Ode to Rura and Snu. The dogs who really did, they did live in the Nu. They were there, they wandered up that hill. They visited each tree and talked to it still. The trees flanked both sides. They were large and they were small. The smells, the sniffs, the whir of being back in the forest was all. It was a short walk, just to the top of the hill. But better, it was better for them. It was better for them still. Anyway, so yeah, they're taking a few more today, it looks like. I filmed it, but it's not good film, so I'm not going to put it up. It's in that carriage machine, I think, that is sold by PG&E company itself. So yeah, I'm surrounded by the lunatics that are intent on decontinuance, that are content on murdering this region, murdering the coastline of California. If you've been to like Hearst Castle, if you've been to San Luis Obispo area, you will already see the trip, you know, driving along the ocean side. You will already see the plunder leaving from San Francisco Bay, going down Highway 1. You will already see the plunder that has happened by this particular group of continuing energy at any cost through a chainsaw. Now, I don't want to get on and get all fiery today about it. There's nothing I can do aside from put these videos out here and hope that somebody hears me, hope that change happens. California has very, very few stop places where there is an actual tree grove. Has very few. So this is where California has hit an end of sentence. It's hitting its filter. Those trees were the filter. Okay. We talk about, you know, oh, this beautiful Bay Area, we always get better air than Sacramento. Well, these filters were right here for that better air of the San Francisco Bay Area. So they're taking down those filters, these old ancient trees. They have special, they don't grow a lot. They stay there for years and years and years. It doesn't mean they're dead. It means they're alive, and they are filters. That's when they are the best. That's when they're the best for the oxygenation. Those little nettles, those nettles that grow are the oldest nettles. They're the smartest nettles. They're coming from that tree that has the knowledge. Remember, it has the dedicated knowledge of all the years. Because it has the dedicated knowledge of all the years of what to do, it's a smarter tree. So they're killing the smarter trees. Okay. Anyway, so yeah, so our filters are going to be gone. And, well, anyway. I wanted to talk about other things, like their attunement pleasure gain from the sound of chainsaw. This X group, this evil group, these people that all deserve to die. I am talking about, immediately. I am talking about they are getting a pleasure. They are getting a pleasure increase in their brain, a serotonin rush, a dopamine rush in their brain from the sound of chainsaw and from the sound of instant. When instant happens to the human race, and when instant happens to a human person, it is a commercial event. It is a like, wow, I flipped on the light switch. It is an instant event that gives them a surge in their brain. When that instant event happens in the brain, they feel an applause. They feel a rush, an endorphin rush. We are talking about an endorphin rush. They are charged with happiness. They are charged with pleasure. So when we try to fight these people, you have to understand they are addicts. They are like drug addicts to killing the trees. They are getting such an instant rush with each fell swoop of a branch. They are getting a charge. All right? So we're talking about the pleasure sequence in their brain is so demented that it prefers the sound of chainsaw and the death of the tree by instant. Instantaneous. It is their power. It is their control. All of a sudden. And they are charged by that control. They are absolutely empowered by their control over all other human beings. That guy in that tree right now, in that little bucket, is empowered. He feels as if he is God, if you believe in God. So let you go there. In his instant,